Tourism is one of the biggest industries in the world. But tourism becomes like a machine and holidays lose all meaning. Traveling is more than going from one point to another. And travelers deserve more than being treated like a walking wallet. The future of tourism is about humans showing humans their special place. To understand how this is done, I'm talking today to Andrew Morten. He's founder and managing director of Travel Essence. My name is Martin Roos. Welcome to the Business Debate. Andrew, welcome. 12 years ago, you founded Travel Essence. What was the motivation for that?
Well, I'm a New Zealander, and I moved to Europe about 20 years ago for love. And when I got here, I started looking around, because I've been in the tourism industry for about 25 years. And I started looking around at how New Zealand was being represented in Europe. And what I saw were basically a kind of holiday that personally, I wouldn't want to see my own country like that. So I was looking around and thought, what can I do to give European travelers a proper look at what is, let's be realistic, probably the most beautiful country in the world?
So what is your company actually doing?
We created Travel Essence to focus on small scale properties, so unique, special things. And we customize a holiday for every single client into something that suits their wishes.
So what's the difference? Big companies, they're doing the same, don't they?
Yes and no. They sell holidays and so do we, and I think that's really about the difference. We customize each holiday. We focus on staying in somewhere unique, meeting the locals. So instead of staying in a three-star hotel, you'll go and stay in a small bed and breakfast, a cottage, a villa, but you're staying with local people, and the key is they are sharing their place with you. So it's not about you staying somebody somewhere, it's about you going somewhere and meeting the locals and actually getting a deeper insight into a destination and doing something special for you.
This is a big industry, actually. What sort of places the people are looking for?
So when we started Travel Essence, I did a lot of research into the market, what people were looking for, and overwhelmingly, in excess of 80% of people want small-scale, unique properties. They don't want the three-star hotel, the standard experience. They're actually looking for that personal interaction. So what we've done is we've found a way to actually transact that on a larger scale.
So the people want the human touch, actually.
People want the human touch.
And 99% of your customers, they would come again, they would book you again, they would recommend you again.
Yep.
So what actually is the key of your success?
Well, it's twofold. You've got to be soft with your customers. You've got to spend time with your customers. You need to be able to adapt to what they need. And you need to do the same for your suppliers, because a lot of them are small businesses. They're not used to working with international agents on the other side of the world. So you need to be gentle with your customers. You need to be gentle with your suppliers. But in the middle of the business, where the clients are running through your system, that needs to be perfect. That's a very tight business process. There's a lot of automation going on there. So you can't buy a holiday from us on the internet. You need to come to one of our offices, or we'll come to you. We'll sit down. We'll have a nice conversation together. We'll ask you a lot of questions. We want to understand who you are and why you're going on this holiday. But when it's time to actually organize that holiday, we have very strong internal systems and automation and unique automation to us that enables us to do that in a scale that people can't otherwise achieve.
We're talking about the big market. I cannot imagine, isn't there any other company or agency who's doing the same as you?
Look, I think from a business process, the large scale companies are automated. I think when you look at on the, you know, the personal side, the large scale companies struggle with that, because they actually typically don't know what the destination is, what they're sending people to. So then you've got the small scale agencies, but typically they're run by people who love holidays and love traveling, and they're very passionate about the travel element, but they're not very strong on the business element. So for them, it becomes very difficult to create any meaningful scale.
The way of traveling is changing. I can imagine the whole market will change in 5 or 10 years.
I think the market's already changing. I think we only need to look at companies like Airbnb to realize that people are moving towards that small scale. They want that. But people who are mid-market and above, who are a little bit older and a little bit higher educated, they are often using an intermediary because they don't have time to arrange their own holidays. And I think if the intermediaries are focused only on the large scale, I think it would be fair to say that any company who can't evolve into doing the small scale properties and unique holidays, I think they'll be struggling to survive in the next 10 years.
What's about your own holidays? Are you a travel lunatic? Are you crazy about traveling?
In some ways. I know what good holidays and what good travel's about because I have traveled a lot, but I have three kids and that means I have very special demands. You know, I've got small children. I don't have time to arrange it all myself. So actually what I need is I need travel essences for all sorts of destinations. So in a couple of hours, I can say what it is that I want from my holiday and then have somebody else do all the work.
Andrew, thank you very much and good luck.
Thank you.